Hey, what's going on everybody, and welcome back to another Python tutorial. In today's video we're going to be taking a look at timers, so let's go ahead and just jump right in. Go ahead and load up your scripting layout, and if you don't have one, just go over here and find the scripting workspace, and then we can just arrange the layout to something more comfortable. So as I mentioned, we're going to be looking at timers. So the first one is going to be in a certain amount of time we want something to happen. So let's go ahead and create a new script, click new. And as always, we need to import the Blender Python modules. So type import bpy, type def in underscore 5 underscore seconds, open and close parentheses and add a colon. So after 5 seconds, we want something to happen. We could print a message. This will be printed in the system console, so if you want to see that, make sure you go over here, go to window and toggle the system console. And by default it's quite small, so I'm going to hold control and scroll up the middle mouse wheel. So after 5 seconds the message will be printed in here. What we could also do is actually maybe add something into the 3D scene. So press A, select all of these and just delete them. Then I'm going to shift A, let's go to mesh, I'm going to add in a cube. Now whilst we're hovered over this, we can press Ctrl C just to copy this, then go over here, Ctrl V and paste this in. We now need to call this, because if we press run script nothing will happen, so let's go down here and we can call this by typing bpy.app.timers.register and open and close parentheses. Then within here we're going to type in underscore 5 underscore seconds, which is the name of our function. Then I'm going to add a comma and then type first underscore interval equals, and then we can just add a time, so we said 5 seconds. So now if we hit run script, if we wait around 5 seconds, we should see a cube now appear. We can also see the message in the system console, and we can see it displays our message, which is good. So it's pretty simple, but it's a great way to add a timer, depending if you want to wait after a certain amount of time. Again, this could be more than 5 seconds. This can be as long or as short as you want. We could also run something a set amount of times within a set amount of seconds, which is what we're going to look at now. So let's get rid of all this. First, we're going to create a global variable and we're going to call this counter. So counter equals 0. So this counter will go up to 10. So I'm going to type def run underscore 10 underscore times, open and close parentheses, add a colon. So again, for this example I'm going to add a cube. We already have this copied, so I'm going to press Ctrl V, just paste this back in. Since we're going to add 10 of them, we might as well change the location as well. So location equals open and close parentheses, then within here I'm going to type 0 comma 0 comma 0, and I will come back to this in a second. Next, we want to make this counter go up, so let's go to a new line. Now, since we're using this global variable, we actually need to reference it. So I'm going to type global counter. So now we've referenced this, we can actually use it. So let's make this counter go up by 1. So I'm going to type counter plus equals 1. So essentially, it's going to take our counter and it's going to plus 1. Now, if you want to debug this and you want to see this counter go up, you want to print this to the console. We can do that. Print, open and close parentheses, and then within here just type counter. So now we can say when it does reach 10, we want you to stop. So we're going to say if counter is equal to, so that's two equal signs. If it's equal to 10, then add a colon. Then we want to return none. Then hit enter. Though if it's less than 10, we want to return 1. So this is every 1 second. Again, you can speed this up or slow this down. Since this is a float, we could say 0.5, so it'd be half a second, whatever you want. Then just like before, we need to call this. So on the beginning of a new line, let's type bpy.app.timers.register, open and close parentheses. Then inside here, run underscore 10 underscore times. So when this timer is called, it's going to add a cube, it's going to make the counter go up 1, and it's going to do that every half a second. When the counter is equal to 10, it's just going to stop the timer. But then if we look over here, the location is 0. it's going to add all these cubes in the exact same spot, which I don't want, so I'm just going to delete this one. So what I'm going to do is just go over here, create another global variable, call this location. So location equals 0. And again, we need to call the variable like we did here. So I'm just going to do this up here, type global location. So then for our location, let's move this on the Y and get rid of the 0 and type location. And then down here after the counter, let's copy this, paste it in, and change this from counter to location. So then we can change this to maybe 2. So now when we run the script, every half a second it will add a cube. It will also move it along the y-axis, and then when it's done it 10 times it will stop. So let's go ahead and make sure this works. And there we go. So there's a lot more things we could do with timers, and in fact it does get even more complex. There is some official documentation I will link to, so go ahead and check out our blog post. If you want to see more videos involving timers, let me know in the comments below. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, or at least found it helpful. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.